In Islam, the ends do not justify the means. This idea is totally alien to Islam. In Islam, what is halal is halal, what is haram is haram. We do not bend our law, our morality, for our short-term aims. Never. And we never lose the moral high ground. If we know anything as Shias of Muhammad, as Shias of Ali, as Shias of Hassan, as Shias of Hussein, we know that keeping the moral high ground is key. Once we lose the moral high ground, we are no different from the rest of the non-Muslims, from the rest of those human beings who live their lives as animals, bending any rule to fulfill any desire. Once we do that, we are lost.
In Islam, to believe is to know. To disbelieve is not to know. That is what it fundamentally comes down to. It is to remain ignorant, to cover up knowledge. After all, what is kafir? Kafir comes from the root word, which means to cover up, to conceal. The kafir is the one who covers up that knowledge which is clear. The French orientalist scholar Lamennes, he once wrote that the Quran is not far from considering unbelief, disbelief, as an infirmity, as an illness, as a disease of the human mind. SubhanAllah. Non-Muslims point this out to us. And of course, the kafir, the disbelievers, the atheists who remain deaf and stubborn to the teachings of Islam, the rational message of the Quran, they are described in the Quran as, quote, a people of no intelligence. Allah describes them. Not of no morality, not of no belief, a people of no intelligence. Because they are incapable of the intellectual effort it requires to shake off those blind prejudices, to shake off those easy assumptions about this world, about the existence of God. In this respect, the Quran describes the atheists as cattle of those who go with the crowd, and do not stop and wonder about this world.
All of these ulama unanimously agree that at the very minimum, if Yazid was not a kafir, then at the very minimum, he was a fasir, a transgressor, a breaker of Islamic laws, a corrupt individual, a tyrant, a killer, a drunkard, a dog lover, a music lover, a homosexual, a paedophile, a sexual deviant, someone who slept with his own mother, astaghfirullah. These are their views of these ulama in their books, not my view, not Imam Hussein's view, not Ayatollah Sistani's view. This is their view about Yazid. It's all there in black and white. Yet Allah should be pleased with such a man, astaghfirullah. Allah should be pleased with him. Indeed, the fact is, and this is important, Yazid is not simply a fasir. He was an out and out kafir.